All right, guys, I'm having to use a different camera. I apologize if you notice the difference in quality. The T3i that I've been using for a very long time has lost its mind. I have formatted the card. I have replaced the batteries completely, made sure they were freshly charged, and I can get about 2 minutes before it says recording has been automatically stopped. And it's hard to shoot a video in 2 minutes when you got a lot more to talk about. But anyway, I digress. So plan B, where I'm back on the old camcorder, and we're gonna keep on going. So wanted to give you an update on the KR33 version 2. If you follow me on Instagram, which I hope you do, but if you don't, now would be a great time to go follow me, Neo7CNC on Instagram. I spammed out maybe 6 or so pictures today of an awesome opportunity that I had. Be sure to go follow me on Instagram. You'll see what I was talking about. And it really puts this guy in perspective. I'll just leave it at that. But back to this guy. So just to recap, this is going to be a 4-axis machine. We've got a removable 4-axis that can go on the table so we can do some 4-sided pieces. We have a 2.2 kilowatt Chinese off of eBay spindle that we're going to try. This is going to be my first run with a true spindle. This is an ER20, call it, that's on here. This is water cooled. That's why we have this. This is some airline that I got from Automation Direct, but I'm going to use it for water. Got some 8mm bulkheads on the back on this little bracket that I made to kind of hold the bulkhead specifically, and then I can route the cooling lines off the back of the machine. But we're looking at a travel of about 14 by 9, 14 left to right, 9 front to back, and the Z is going to be somewhere around 5. So where the machine is, if you saw the video I did where I was talking about the Masso CNC controller that's capable of doing all the way to 5-axis, that's a Kickstarter project that's still going on now. They're not funded yet. I would hope that something like that would make funding, because I definitely see the value in it. And if you're trying to get away from Mach 3, Mach 4, or a PC-based controller solution, the Masso is the fix for that, at least right now. So be sure to check that video out. I'll do something or a card or whatever, so you can check that video out, maybe even link below. While you still have time, if you want to get in on the Kickstarter. Let's see. So in order to do that video, I had to tune the servos. So that means that this machine, by way of the Masso, I can jog it around, I can move it, I can run parts, whatever. But until we get the spindle spinning, I haven't really fussed around with any of that. So the only thing left to do, there's two things that are keeping me from running the spindle. The first is the spindle needs some power. This is a 3-phase spindle. It needs 3 wires to get those phases to the machine or to the spindle, and it requires a VFD, a variable frequency drive. And so this VFD came with the kit, and so this runs on 220 AC single phase, and it outputs 3-phase to the motor. So in order to make this run, to make that run, I had to put in 220 in the shop. And again, if you follow me on Instagram, you saw me post a picture of the panel and said, hey, this isn't much, this is not an exciting picture, but it is kind of a milestone, because now I actually have the power in the shop to run the VFD, to run the spindle. So by way of the installation that I did and this SO cord here with this monster twist lock plug on it, we're going to be able to get the 220 to the VFD. So then we got to get the power from the VFD to the spindle. That poses its own problems. This is the connector that came with the spindle, and it looks like that cable grip is somewhere in the neighborhood of 8mm, and the cable that I have is a lot larger than 8mm. So I'm not sure how I'm going to do this just yet. I've got another cable coming from IGUS, a sample cable coming from IGUS, and I'm hoping it'll be better, smaller diameter. I'm not so sure. I only need 3 conductors, but the cable that I found so far has been 16-4, so it's a 16-gauge 4 conductor, and that's what this is. This is kind of unruly. It doesn't like to bend. The shielding isn't as flexible as I'd like. And I've seen online where people say that shielding is important, because you don't want that 3-phase power that you're running the spindle with, you don't want that to aggravate any of the other electronics on the machine, so shielding is worthwhile. So fingers crossed, hopefully the IGUS cable will work out better. If the sample looks good, I'll go ahead and order whatever I need to run to wire the machine, and then we'll be that much closer. The second thing on the spindle that's tripping me up is that with the kit that I bought off of eBay, it came with this water fountain pump, for lack of a better way to say it. I think that's pretty much what it is. And this runs on 220. Now, I guess, I don't know. I don't really want to run the pump on 220. I'd rather have 220 just for this VFD and the spindle. I don't know if that makes sense or not. But that's posing its own issue, because I'd like to have a 110 or a 120 AC replacement to replace this guy. This runs 3,500 liters an hour, which, if my math is right, that's about 15 and some change gallons a minute. That seems like an awful lot of water to be shoving through here, and I don't know what kind of water pressure this thing's pushing. It says the max head on this is 3.5 meters, so I don't know what that equals to in pressure, but anyway. So if anybody's got any experience with that part of it, anybody that's messed with one of these VFDs or these water-cooled spindles, I'd love to get your input on that. You can leave it in the comments, or you can shoot me an email at questions@neo7cnc.com. I would certainly appreciate it. So once we get that done, then I'll just need to figure out some sort of tank to keep the pump in, and then we'll get water flowing through the system, and then we can turn it on. What else? I had somebody mention that, man, those uprights are going to have to be stabilized. There's no way that's going to work. You may be right. Luckily, the strain on the machine, as far as mass and momentum, is going to be left to right. It's not going to be front to back, because the table's moving. So any momentum of the part or the fourth axis on here, that's going to go straight into the bottom frame. So that won't bleed into this. Plus, I've got some angled 80-20 on the backside that really stiffens this up, and I fully expect that this is going to have to come down, because by the time I drop the Z all the way down, and if I had the four axis on here, or if I don't have the four axis, then I'm still probably 2 or 3 inches off the table. By the time you put a spool board on there, I'm still not touching the part. So I think this whole thing's going to have to come down a couple of inches, but I'm waiting to cut those off when I get closer to that point. So that's basically where it stands at the moment. I've had people indicate interest in the bracket sets. If you're one of those people and you're serious about it, shoot me an email at questions@neo7cnc and just say, you know, KR33 brackets, and we'll talk. I don't have any more to sell. The stock pile that I had, which wasn't many, it was maybe enough for one, maybe 1.5 kits. I've had people buy those out already, so I don't really have anything else. If we were if people need those brackets again, we'll have to do a pre-order, and I'll have to get the CNC shop to make them, unless I can find some other way to do it. So that's where we are. It's coming along. I'm very anxious to get this going, for, you know, whether it's because of the Masso, because of the new spindle, because of the new footprint, the new size, the fourth axis. There's so many things new on here that I really want to play with it. And it'll be a good opportunity to try to do some hand coding for some of the four axis work. I'm kind of twisted like that. So anyway, I just want to understand it better, and I think that would be a great way to do it. Good exercise. So anyway, thanks for sticking around. If you're not a subscriber, please consider it. We'd love to have you. We're working on more CNC stuff. Still got to finish the electrical enclosure for the CNC version 1. It's already inside the big enclosure to keep the dust down, so that looks good. Lots of stuff. So be sure to stick around and subscribe. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. I would appreciate it. I know when I'm watching videos, I usually forget to give it a thumbs up, so that's just a reminder. I'm not begging for it. Y'all know me long enough. I very rarely ask for anything. So, that being said, thanks for sticking around. Special thanks to the Patreons, anybody that's supporting the channel financially, whether it's through Patreon or PayPal. I really appreciate it. It helps kind of keep these things going, and maybe one day I'll build up enough money that I can replace the boat anchor Canon T3i. Yes, Canon, I'm calling you out. For whatever reason, it's lost its mind. So anyway, we'll get around that. But anyway, I said anyway way too many times. We'll talk to you next time.